It was Lunar New Year last week. We decided to do some decor by sprucing up the home with some oriental-themed florals. These are flowers that are 5 days old and still holding up pretty well. Our parents also sent over some cookies from Singapore. It looks a little smashed up here, but we were so happy to have a taste of home. These are pineapple tarts. As you can tell, we have finished more than half of them. And it's snack time for me now. Pineapple tarts are buttery short crust containing a ball of pure pineapple jam inside with a hint of clove. Almond cookies are these little shortbread balls that melt in your mouth. We also had these crispy rolls with stuffed savory pork floss. And this is my favorite, mini spring rolls stuffed with pounded dried shrimp. Yummy! So today I'm going to be sharing some tips on setting up a home kiln, as I've had quite a lot of you ask me about my experience. By the way, if you're wondering why I have a little pooch now, it's because my husband and I are expecting a baby in about 3 months' time. Anyway, last March, I took the plunge and got a small kiln when my studio closed during COVID. At that point, I had absolutely no experience firing a kiln. It was like this elusive process that I heard about during pottery classes, and it further intrigued me to be able to master the end-to-end process of ceramics. I'm so glad I took the plunge to get a kiln because it turned out a lot less daunting than I expected. Hence, I wanted to share some tips based on my experience to encourage anyone out there thinking of getting a small kiln. So my kiln fits the electrical requirements of standard US homes. It is 120 volts and only 0.58 cubic feet in volume, used mainly for firing small pieces and jewelry. I still fire bigger pieces at my community studio. So firstly, what I did was to shortlist kilns based on my pottery needs as well as limitations. Even though I would have preferred a medium-sized kiln for larger items, I didn't want to rewire my home, so I decided on getting a 120-volt kiln. Do note that every kiln has a cone limit that it can fire up to. I wanted it to be able to fire up to at least mid-range, that is around cone 6, which is the cone where you can find a very good selection of commercial glazes. I shortlisted the Olympic MAS-129E, which was the biggest kiln that could fire up to cone 8 and was within my budget. It fits around 8 standard size mugs for glaze firing. Next, I checked the kiln specifications. Important specs to take note of are the voltage, the phase, it should be single, the number of amps, and the plug type. So from your kiln specs, you should work out how many amps your circuit breaker should be. Circuit breakers can only handle about 80% of their overall amps, so for my 16 amp kiln, I needed a breaker size of at least 20 amps. Thirdly, I checked my circuit breaker board at home to see whether the kiln was able to be used. Standard US outlets have 15 and 20 amp breakers, and there are also non-standard outlets that have breakers from 30 to 50 amps. The higher the breaker size, it means they carry wiring that are thicker, higher quality, meant for more heavy-duty appliances located in the kitchen or bathroom. Identify the outlets that you can use by matching them to the legend on your circuit board. Next, I narrowed down electricity outlets that fit my kiln plug. If your kiln plug type is nema 515P, your plug should be able to fit into any standard US home outlet. However, do note that your kiln is likely to require a breaker of 20 amps. Do not plug it in an outlet with a breaker of only 15 amps. If your plug type is nema 520 like mine, some of your homes may have this outlet. these outlets should only be on 20 amp breakers. If your home does not have this outlet, you can call in an electrician to help change the receptacle cover specifically for an outlet with a 20 amp breaker. This should cost you not more than $50, as no rewiring is required. You should never use any adapters for your kiln because it may not be safe. Lastly, I picked an ideal location for firing. The most ideal spot would be a sheltered outdoor space, but I don't have that. In my new space, my kiln is in our guest bathroom. It is ideal for firing as it is not carpeted. I can seal it off from the rest of our living space when firing, and there is a way to ventilate gases out of the house. These requirements are really important as firing burns out organic matter and produces hazardous gases in the first few hours, so you do not want to be in the same room as the kiln when firing. I did not invest in the kiln vent, as it is costly and usually meant for bigger kilns. My bathroom has a built-in vent, which I turn on when I fire. I also shut the door when I fire, but check on it occasionally. And that's all I have for you today. I hope this video was helpful for those who want to set up a kiln at home. If you have any questions, do leave a comment, subscribe to my channel for more of my pottery videos, as well as follow me on Instagram. I've also included some links that might be helpful for you in your search. See you in my next video.